What the?
Sweet. Hey.
What the hell?
Dirt for a dirty mind. What was that?
Chapel tonight. Let's just go put it back and we can pretend this never happened.
Pretend this never happened? How the hell is that going to work? We just saw a ghost. A person who has obviously been dead for a very long time was in the room with us.
What do you want to do? Wait for her to show up again and then ask her politely to have never shown up in the first place?
What is this key unlock?
How the hell should I know?
I want to know this key unlocks.
Why?
Because I need to understand this. I need to understand so that I can go on living peacefully.
Pants!
John, don't look around like that. Ghosts don't appear in the daytime.
No, Emma. As far as I know, ghosts don't appear at all.
John, check it out. I found a quill and dagger pin.
So there's absolutely nothing buried in this shithole except for a haunted key and a quill and dagger pin. I'm happy I never got into that society.
I know someone in Quill and Dagger who also happens to be up around daybreak a lot. Andy?
Hey! Nothing much, you? Yeah, I knew you were up because you always used to write on my wall at 5 a.m. saying you had studying to do. Yeah, I have a bit of mystery here that I was hoping you could help me with.
Do you know anything about a key buried in a shady room in the basement of Sage Chapel?
Shit, son! Okay, alright, thanks, Andy.
All Andy's been told is that she was a Cornell student who died in the gorges.
Gorge death, you say?
Yes.
My freshman year roommate used to be, like, obsessed with gorge deaths for some reason. He's a tour guide now. I think he actually works Sundays. We could go hit him up.
Why not? I don't intend on doing anything until I figure this shit out.
Hey there, John.
Hey,
John.
She's not my girlfriend.
So, you guys think you saw Anna Dobson?
Who?
She threw herself into the gorge back in 1871, right after fiancé died of tuberculosis. She's buried in Sage Chapel. Her father's a big shot trustee at the time.
How the hell do you know all this?
I'm paid according to how many random bits of information about Cornell I can store in my mind. No, but seriously, I just always had this fascination with gorge deaths.
I know it's a little creepy, but once you get over that initial creepiness and as you start thinking about gorge deaths, it's pretty fascinating stuff. The gorges entail two types of deaths. There's the drunk people and then the suicides. It's kind of like the really happy and then the really sad.
Look, bro, I'm sorry, but we don't have time to hear your entire treatise on the philosophy of gorge deaths.
Some other time, maybe?
When John called, you said you had something to give us. That's why we're meeting up with you?
Yes. So, my freshman year, I was walking down in the gorges, and I found this chest. I think your key might have been the key to that chest.
Can we have it?
Nope. I broke the chest into 1,000 pieces. Violence opens most chests as well as keys do. Anyway, here's what was inside.
That which makes my heart beat most is not within this homely chest. It sleeps at the feet of my dear provost. Without it, I shan't ever rest. Anna Dobson was no Shakespeare.
I know. It'd almost be funny if you guys hadn't seen a ghost.
So, something is buried somewhere, and we have to give it to the ghost?
Provost. My dear provost. Who's that?
Probably either Ezra or A.D. White.
Okay. Tonight we dig a hole in the art squad.
Are you crazy?
Probably. I saw a ghost, remember?
All right, let's go. Michael, thanks, man. We really gotta hang out sometime.
Yeah, wait a sec. I'd like to know what it is that somebody could love so much that they wouldn't want to go to heaven or hell without it.
Sure thing, bro. We'll keep you posted.
So, tonight's the night, eh?
It could be fucking anywhere. We don't even know which provost she meant. We are never gonna find this thing.
I think she's telling us where to dig.
We doing this?
Yes. To lock it. Is this your fiancé?
Thank you.
John.
Yes, Emma?
Do now?
I have no idea. Let's walk.
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking how incredibly romantic it is that she refused to rest in peace until she found that picture of her fiancé.
Actually, I was thinking it's a pretty cool world in which things like this can happen.
What, tuberculosis and suicide?
No. Crazy adventures with people you care about. Kind of takes away your fear of death. At least a little. This is the first time you let me come to your place.
Yeah, I thought you might want to meet some of my housemates.